And let's now get more analysis on the escalating tensions in and around Syria from investigative journalist Michael Collin. Mr. Collin, thank you very much indeed for joining us here at RT. So again, these recent revelations by the Syrian army indicate again that the rebels may be using chemical weapons. Will these allegations be investigated as well? What do you think?
Well, I don't think there will be a serious investigation from the Western side, because actually they don't look for the truth. They just look for a pretext to overthrow Assad and to take control of Syria. And this is really a strategic goal. After Syria, they will try to get control of Palestinians, Lebanon, Iran. And all this actually is part of their general strategy to take control of Russia against over Asia, against Russia and China. So they don't want an investigation. They don't want the truth. They just want a pretext.
All right. So, and this actually, what you just said, answers many questions. But still, why are the media and international governments largely putting the blame on Assad? And we've heard from France, from the UK, from Sweden, Turkey, who have no doubt it's the government behind the attack. They are sold. What's their evidence?
Well, they have no evidence and they know it. Actually, they just want a pretext. And as I said before many times, in every war, you've got what I'm calling the five principles of propaganda war. This is to say, if you are the West and you want to take control of a country for resources or for strategic position, you have first to hide the interest, the economic interest. You have second to hide the history and what colonialism did in this region to divide the people. Third, you have to demonize the country you are going to attack. And this is it. We have a campaign since 2 years to demonize the government in Syria. Third, you have to pretend that you are actually making an intervention to help the victim. So it is largely known that the rebels are coming atrocities, but they are always presented as the victim. And this is the fourth principle of propaganda war. And the fifth is to monopolize, to prevent that there is a debate and that the people think, okay, you have conflicts, you have two interests, two versions, so I have to hear the two versions. And those are the classical principles of propaganda war used in every conflict.
But what we're seeing now, do you think this military build-up, this military escalation in the region is a sign of possible nearing intervention?
Everything is always possible for them, but it's also obvious that they see the danger. They see that they have no majority in Syria and the area. The resistance is really very strong. So I believe it is more a pressure to negotiate, because they know also they are not so strong anymore.
Yeah. Also, President Obama said there's not enough facts to prove Assad carried out the attack. Why prepare for a military response then?
Well, you have to consider the weakening position of the United States in all the region. They have to do something, but they don't know what to do. Look, their allies in Egypt are getting weak. In Tunisia, the same. There are many criticisms in Turkey for the role they have played against Syria. The role of Qatar is very obvious, that it is really a factory of media lies with Al Jazeera. And this is also object of a lot of criticism. There has been a change at the head of Qatar. So I think they have to do something to try to change the balance of the forces, but they don't really know what they are going to do.
All right, investigative journalist Michel Collin, thank you very much indeed for your time, sir.
Thank you. Welcome.